Well, data from the Small Business Administration show nearly 12,000 Indiana businesses received loans of at least $150,000 as part of a federal program to address the COVID-19 economic crisis.
The Payment Protection Program, or PPP, is part of the CARES Act, which is designed to provide direct payments to small businesses to keep workers on the payroll. But it's not just small businesses that we found on the list. There's a very, very big one, too. We're digging deeper into that tonight.
Parkview Health counts for more than 13,000 full and part-time employees on its payroll. Its economic impact across our region? Huge. So when ABC21 dug deeper into the latest data released on the Paycheck Protection Program, theirs was a name that flew off the page. We weren't the only one who found it odd.
When you look at an entity the size of the healthcare company, the limit was 500 employees. Now there's some NAICS codes and some different things that would get you above 500 on PPP1 or 300 on PPP2. So when you have an employer that employs thousands of people, they should have been disqualified right up front.
Brian Sandvich, who heads up regulatory compliance and investigations for an accounting firm in New York City, specializes in matters involving fraud. He's also a former inspector general for the New York State Department of Labor.
These were very good programs designed to help out individuals and to help out businesses keeping people on the payroll.
We searched the PPP loan data organized by the nonprofit group ProPublica and then confirmed through a search of the raw data from the Small Business Administration that Parkview Health was approved for a $1.1 million PPP loan on February 9th. But that loan marked not fully disbursed. So we reached out to Parkview. The communications director was as surprised as we were to learn that the healthcare giant had been okayed for a seven-figure forgivable loan. Following closer review, she told us, quote, "After further investigation, we've learned that no Parkview Health entity has applied for a PPP loan. We have contacted the Department of Justice and the Small Business Administration to report suspected fraud."
It is unusual when you see large entities being a victim of fraud like this.
We reached out to three Small Business Administration officials and the Department of Justice, all of whom who say they cannot comment on individual cases.
You have to create documents for this entity, payroll records and financial statements and the information that would have accompanied the loan application.
But how common is PPP loan fraud? Sandvich says it's happening more than you might think.
Current statistics are saying about 5% of this, of government funds are subject to fraud, waste, and abuse. When you look at the trillions of dollars between the three stimulus packages that have already been approved, you can quickly see how large those numbers are going to ultimately be.
Sandvich has been working to compile data showing just how big an issue PPP loan fraud is. He shared that data with us. In it, it says $626 million in funds have been seized or forfeited as a result of civil and criminal investigations involving the EIDL and PPP programs by the DOJ.
This is literally going to be the tip of the iceberg. There are, over 150,000 hotline complaints already received by the SBA's IG's office.
What is the benefit that the scammer has, if any, to doing this?
I'm sure the goal was to cash the check. Ultimately, those funds would have been wired into the account. When you actually do the application, you actually put where you want the funds to be wired to, because this was all done through an electronic transfer. So that information would have been included in the your application as to where you wanted the funds.
So where does Parkview go from here?
They're a victim. So, ultimately, they want to get it cleared up.
Again, the Justice Department not commenting on this specific matter, but it did recently acknowledge the scope of the problem. As of late March, 474 different defendants had been charged with crimes tied to the Paycheck Protection Program or to two other pandemic relief efforts. And the prosecutor in charge of the crackdown, he has this message for would-be scammers.
To anyone thinking of using the global pandemic as an opportunity to scam and steal from hardworking Americans, my advice is simple. Don't. No matter where you are or who you are, we will find you and prosecute you to the fullest extent of the law.
If you know something that should be reported, we've put the info that you'll want in our story posted online right now. That's WPTA21.com.